From MTN News, this is Montana This Morning.
Coming up here, our dry spring seems to be getting drier. Coming up, the drought outlook for this season from our MTN meteorologists. And Bozeman firefighters got a really unique rescue call this weekend. Find out what happened to this dog and how firefighters got the pooch out of this problem. Well, it is 6:30 for you. It is Monday. Holly Brantley, Chet Lehman. You're watching Montana This Morning. Chet is out on the patio without a coat, but nothing else. That's never really stopped you before.
Well, I have a coat on. Yeah, no, that's enough. It's only 30 out here. It's not all that bad.
Matt is our pansy other than me. And
yeah, well, that's
you're
yeah,
tougher.
It's 30 degrees. I'm not going to be out here that long anyway.
So balmy.
It's lovely with the clouds showing a little color out here. It is absolutely beautiful out right now. Like I said, 30 degrees on the patio, 30 in Dillon, 29 in Whitehall right now, 24 in Butte with some pretty good fog. That ranges out towards Deer Lodge where it's currently 30 degrees. West Yellowstone currently at 28. As far as your day goes, this is what we're looking at. We're going to warm it up into those mid-50s for the most part for the Bozeman area with we'll call it mostly sunny skies for Butte. Same kind of thing there. You can see the fog behind that shot. Low to mid-50s for the Butte area today with mostly sunny skies once the fog burns off. And then a little bit of change in store, maybe some above average temperatures by the time we get to the middle to the end of this week. I'll have the details of that, Holly, coming up in about 10 minutes.
Thank you, Chet. We are now in the rainy season and we are praying for a lot of rain. May and June are the two wettest months of the year. However, the last 5 months have been abnormally dry and drought conditions are growing aggressively across the state. Chief Meteorologist Mike Hurd fills us in on current drought conditions.
Growing drought conditions continue over the western United States and Montana. A year ago, there was no drought in the state of Montana, but a year later, we have extreme drought already building in northeastern Montana and moderate drought conditions in southwest Montana. The Montana Drought Advisory Committee held their first drought update last Thursday, and Dillon was a main topic.
Dillon went 383 days with less than 6 inches of total precip. That's pretty, that's over a year with less than 6 inches, and that was broken last month, but that's the second longest stretch on record.
Lower valley snowpack has pretty much melted out, but the higher snowpack seems to be holding in place despite recent warm weather. April has been a huge disappointment for precipitation, especially in Beaverhead County.
It really highlights how dry this month has been so far, especially across southwestern Montana. The Bitterroot, Big Hole, Upper Clark Fork, Beaverhead, those areas where we've been seeing melt, maybe some early peaks as well. April has been notoriously dry, but it's been notably dry.
Drought conditions will likely persist or worsen through the end of July across most of Montana.
Mountain snowpack alone will not get us out of a drought situation this year. It's critical that we have a normal rainy season in the month of May and in June. Because today, the last day of April, it's in the 80s, we got a lot of wind. That's only going to aggravate the drought situation in our region. So we should see about 2 to 3 inches of rain per location per month in the month of May and June. That is vital. If we fall short, drought conditions will get much worse. Praying for rain here at Clark Canyon Reservoir, I'm Chief Meteorologist Mike Hurd for MTN News.
Our Storm Tracker team of meteorologists will update drought conditions weekly on Thursday when the Montana Drought Monitor is updated. 6:33 now. It's no secret President Biden wants to raise taxes on some wealthier Americans and on corporations in order to fund massive projects like paid family and infrastructure reform. But how does the U.S. compare to other countries when it comes to funding these programs? Our Joe St. George is looking overseas for us.
Free community college, paid family leave, modern infrastructure, preschool for all of these proposals President Biden wants to pass over the next several months.
As negotiations continue here on Capitol Hill this week, one argument President Biden is making is that the U.S. lags behind the rest of the world on some things and that inaction benefits America's competitors. So what are other countries offering their citizens?
Let's examine parental leave. All of these countries, considered to be economic competitors of the United States, offer some form of guaranteed paid parental leave when a new child is born. The U.S. is one of the only developed nations that does not mandate this benefit. In fact, in the United Kingdom, 52 weeks of maternity leave is guaranteed by the government if a new mom chooses to take it, with most of it paid. In the United States, jobs are protected, but pay is not guaranteed. A recent analysis by the Bureau of Labor and Statistics found just 21% of workers have access to paid leave. Some states, like California, have passed their own policies because of inaction at the federal level. President Biden's plan calls for 12 weeks of paid parental leave. Benefits would be a percentage of a worker's earnings, with a maximum benefit of $4,000 a month. The cost, $225 billion over the next 10 years. It's not just paid parental leave, the White House says the U.S. lags. Experts say China is spending around three times more than the U.S. on infrastructure, which has led President Biden to say this in the Oval Office.
If we don't get moving, they're going to eat our lunch.
Of course, offering these perks would require changes. It has to be paid for. The White House says corporate taxes and income tax rates on individuals making over $400,000 would be raised, but many conservatives argue all this rapid spending is unwise and represents too much government, believing raising corporate taxes would make the U.S. worse off compared to some other countries. For instance, Ireland, the U.K., and the United Arab Emirates all offer lower corporate tax rates right now than the United States. In Washington, I'm Joe St. George.
Here at home, the University of Montana and tech companies have been the ideal model for success. MTN's Russ Thomas has more on the University of Montana's ATG connection.
In recent years, the University of Montana has been working to team up with local businesses to give their students more opportunities for work-based experience to enhance their skill set upon graduation.
The relationship they've developed with ATG's Missoula-based office is at the forefront of this effort.
We think it's really important that we work directly with employers and industry leaders to tailor programs to meet workforce demands, both here in Missoula and across Montana. And then the Aim Higher program with ATG is really a blueprint for what successful partnership between employers and education can look like.
ATG Executive Director Kim Corwin says everyone benefits from this partnership, the university, ATG, and the students.
It's been really important since day one with the ATG, with founding ATG, to have that relationship with the University of Montana. We've always had these incredible ideas. It's very much been a reciprocal relationship in saying, how can we best set up our students for success post-graduation? And then us to say, how can we best set up students for success during their college years so that they're ready afterward?
While the partnership has been in place for several years, it was 2018 when it really ramped up, when Cognizant acquired ATG, and in 2019 started the Aim Higher program. An intense 12-week program to train students from the ground up on every facet of what ATG does. This opened the door for more current students as well as UM alumni. Andrea Bowman graduated with a degree in marketing and managing. She says the education she got from U of M has been a springboard for her success at ATG.
I had a lot of leadership classes and a lot of classes around innovation and marketing, and even though we are consulting and we're implementing a product, that marketing comes into play because you're constantly working with clients, you are marketing yourself to them, and you're letting them know that you're going to perform a good job for them.
UM alum Haley Hall says this partnership has brought her more than she could have ever expected. She's come a long way from her tiny eastern Montana hometown of Broadus.
Our technology was really limited to dial-up internet and, for the majority, landlines. And so reflecting on that now in my career is, you know, it's just really special because I never thought that I would have the opportunity to work in tech. It wasn't something that I even thought of as a possibility.
Lindsay Jones graduated from the university this weekend and says the UM-ATG partnership has facilitated what she believes will be a successful career.
Everybody's been so kind and so forthcoming with just embracing us with open arms into the little ATG family. It's not, I guess, a little family anymore.
Now, Bodner says they currently have over 175 UM graduates working at ATG Cognizant's Missoula-based office, which makes up roughly two-thirds of their total workforce. In Missoula, I'm Russ Thomas, MTN News.
ATG's next Aim Higher training program session is scheduled for this summer. Well, 6:38 now. Curiosity problems aren't just for cats. The Bozeman Fire Department responds to many calls, most involving people, but not limited to just us. This weekend, for example, crews say they were caught off guard by a four-legged friend in need of rescuing. The Bozeman Fire Department caught these photos of a unique call when this dog's owner brought him to their department with his head caught in a wheel. You see him there. Oh, poor baby. Crews tell us they tried a few different tactics, but ultimately had to use tools often used for freeing people from wreckage to get the dog out. Wait till you see the wheel. The team worked alongside the owner to safely cut and spread the steel away from the dog's neck. Yes, the steel. And were successful. The crew at the Bozeman Fire Department said it's a point of appreciation when someone in need comes to them for help. The dog is expected to be just fine after that intense ordeal. Wow, we wish them all the best and thank you to the firefighters. Well, coming up here, everyone in the pool may not even be possible this summer, and it's actually got nothing to do with the pandemic. What's causing the problem? That's coming up. But first, here's a look at what's ahead at 7 on CBS this morning.
Good morning. Ahead on CBS this morning, Senator Elizabeth Warren joins us with how she plans to help millions of American parents struggling with child care as businesses and workplaces reopen all around the country. Plus, meet the four Americans set to make history as the first all-civilian mission to space and learn what each crew member represents. Also, actress Juliana Margulies has a new memoir. The Emmy Award winner talks with us about her life and how a message from George Clooney changed her career. Still waiting for my message from George Clooney. Maybe it'll come in this hour. We'll see at 7.